हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू गेट एकेडमी ग्लोबल। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस फीडबैक एम्पलीफायर। दिस टॉपिक इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर ऑल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स, इलेक्ट्रिकल एंड इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन स्टूडेंट्स। इन फीडबैक एम्पलीफायर व्हाट आई विल कवर इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ फीडबैक एम्पलीफायर इन टॉपिक वन, दैट मीन इन फर्स्ट वीडियो लेक्चर। इन सेकेंड वीडियो लेक्चर आई विल कवर फ्रिक्वेंसी रिस्पॉन्स ऑफ फीडबैक एम्पलीफायर एंड यू विल इन्जॉय दिस टॉपिक। दिस टॉपिक इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर एवरी वन। इन टॉपिक थ्री we will discuss basic concept of feedback topology. In topic 4 we will discuss classification of feedback topology part 1. In this part 1 I will cover voltage series topology, voltage shunt topology. I will give you detailed idea of voltage series and voltage shunt, that means I will explain you input impedance as well as output impedance. Okay, in next lecture in topic 5 classification of feedback topology in part 2, in this video lecture I will explain you current series topology as well as current shunt topology. Again I will give you good idea of input impedance as well as output impedance. In topic 6 identification of feedback topology with example, I will cover feedback topology with some good example. And in topic 7, that means the video lecture 7, I will cover some good question based on feedback amplifier. Okay, in first lecture, that means introduction of feedback amplifier, so I am starting this topic 1, that means the introduction of feedback amplifier. Okay, here I am considering one adder circuit. The plus terminal, this is the plus minus terminal, this is the source voltage Vs, this is the forward path gain A, the feedback path gain beta. This is the output voltage V naught, this is the output, this is the external source voltage Vs, the source voltage Vs, the VF, that means the feedback voltage, the feedback voltage, the VI, that means the input voltage for this forward path gain, this forward path, or this is the plant gain, the forward path gain, basic amplifier, the forward path gain, or sometimes referred as basic amplifier gain, basic amplifier gain. Okay, this source voltage is the input voltage of this complete structure, that means this is the closed system, this is the feedback structure, this is the Vs, is the source voltage or input voltage for this complete structure. The Vi is the input voltage for this forward path gain or basic amplifier. Sometimes this Vi is also referred as error in case of unity feedback, especially in case of unity feedback system. This is the feedback voltage, this feedback path factor, this is the beta, is feedback path factor, feedback path factor. This feedback path factor sometimes also referred as reverse transmission gain, reverse transmission gain. Okay, from this structure we can write the forward path gain A is equal to V naught, is the output voltage for A, and input voltage Vi for this A. This is the equation number 1. In second equation, input voltage Vi is the result of this adder. This is the adder. This adder is used for addition as well as subtraction of the signal. Result of this adder Vi, the Vs is connected to plus terminal, and this is the feedback voltage is connected to plus minus terminal. That means the equation number 2. Next equation is the feedback path gain, feedback path factor beta, the result of this beta, that means the output for this beta is the Vf, that means the output for this beta is the Vf, and input for this beta is the V naught. So we have overall 3 equations, A, Vi and beta. From equation 1, you can see here, from equation 1, the V naught is given by Avi, where Vi is given by Vs plus minus Vf. From equation 2, from equation number 2, input voltage is given by Vs plus minus Vf, and then from equation number 3, the feedback voltage is given by beta V naught, the feedback voltage is given by beta V naught. We can calculate V naught here 1 minus plus A beta, because here is plus minus, in this side minus 2 plus A beta, this result is A Vs. Overall feedback gain, that means the V naught by Vs, overall gain of this closed system, that means the feedback gain, is given by A upon 1 minus plus A beta. This is the result of this feedback structure. This result is A upon 1 minus plus A beta. You can see here, if feedback voltage is connected, if feedback voltage is connected to the plus minus terminal of this adder, then feedback gain will be A upon 1 minus plus A beta. That means, if feedback voltage is connected to plus, that means this result will be negative. If feedback voltage is connected to the negative terminal, that means this result will be positive. This is the opposite result, the opposite form, is the opposite result or opposite form. Okay? If feedback voltage is connected to positive terminal of adder, positive terminal of adder, this structure is referred as positive feedback. Positive feedback amplifier is the positive feedback amplifier. Okay? If feedback voltage is connected to plus, that means gain of this amplifier is equal to A upon 1 minus A beta. This is the result of positive feedback amplifier. This positive feedback amplifier, or this concept of positive feedback, is used for designing of oscillator, designing of multivibrator. Mainly this positive feedback is used for designing of unstable system like multivibrator, like oscillator. Okay? If this feedback is connected to negative terminal of this adder, that means this feedback voltage is connected to the negative terminal of this adder, this is the VI, that means the feedback gain will be A upon 1 plus A beta, because this feedback voltage is connected to the negative terminal, resulted will be plus A upon 1 plus A beta. This negative feedback, this concept of negative feedback, normally is used for designing of amplifier. In feedback amplifier analysis, we used a negative feedback system. By default, we used a negative feedback system for analysis of amplifier. Normally, negative feedback system increases the stability of the system, and positive feedback system decreases the stability. Okay? So, in general, by default, we use a negative feedback system for designing of amplifier. This feedback gain is referred as A upon 1 plus A beta, where D is equal to 1 plus A beta. This D is referred as D sensitivity. This D is referred as D sensitivity, and A beta is referred as loop gain. A beta is referred as loop gain. Here, we can describe one of the important terminology, that means the sensitivity. The sensitivity is defined as change in feedback gain with respect to change in forward gain. And the resultant of this sensitivity is equal to 1 upon 1 plus A beta. And 1 plus A beta is referred as desensitivity. That means sensitivity is equal to the 1 upon D. Even you can derive this sensitivity result, that means 1 upon 1 plus A beta. How you can derive? If del AF upon AF divided by del A by A, that means the change in feedback gain with respect to change in forward path gain, that means the change in overall feedback path gain with respect to change in forward path gain. Okay? I am explaining you. If AF is equal to A upon 1 plus A beta, okay? If sensitivity is defined as delta AF upon AF divide delta A by A, and this result is written as A upon AF into del AF upon del A. A upon AF, this is the A upon AF, that means the feedback gain, A upon 1 plus A beta. And this is the derivative of this feedback gain with respect to A, the derivative of feedback gain with respect to A. So, 1 plus A beta whole square, 1 plus A beta derivative of A, that means the 1 minus A, derivative of 1 plus A beta, that means the 0 plus beta. A beta is cancel out, the resultant is A cancel out, 1 plus A beta in numerator, this result is 1 upon 1 plus A beta square. 1 plus A beta is cancel out, that means the result of this sensitivity is 1 upon 1 plus A beta. the sensitivity result is 1/1 plus A beta, where D is the desensitivity. You can note down some of the important point. For the high reliability of closed system, for the high reliability of feedback system, the value of sensitivity should be very, very small. For the high reliability of the system, the value of sensitivity should be very small. That means the value of sensitivity should be very small. That means if S is very, very less, that means desensitivity is very, very high. That means 1 plus A beta is very, very high. 1 plus A beta very, very high. That means the A beta is very, very high. For the high reliability of system, the value of loop gain should be very, very high for designing of the system. Okay. If I am considering, okay, you can see here, if I am considering the changes in A, suppose in changes in A, is suppose 10% due to temperature, you can assume due to temperature, then overall changes in the system, if I am considering delta AF upon AF, del A upon A, that means the sensitivity 1/1 plus A beta, if A is 100 and beta is 10, that means the loop gain A beta is 1000. Okay, is the high loop gain. 1 plus A beta, we can write approximately A beta, that means the 1000. In this case, changes in overall system with respect to changes in basic amplifier gain is equal to 1/1000 approximately. That means changes in feedback gain, overall feedback gain is equal to delta A upon A divided by 1000. The delta A by A, that means the changes due to temperature, suppose if the 10% divided by 1000, that means 0.01%. This is the advantage of feedback. Feedback decreases the value of sensitivity. That means feedback increases the reliability of the system. This is the advantage of feedback. So that means del AF upon AF, this result, del AF upon AF, the overall changes in the closed system will be only 0.01%. If the changes in this forward path gain is 10% due to temperature, then overall changes in the system will be only 0.01%. This is the advantage of feedback. Okay. So here I am explaining you the sensitivity is equal to 1/d. For the high reliability of system, the value of d sensitivity should be very high. That means the value of loop gain should be very high. If loop gain is very high, A beta is very, very high, that means feedback gain will be approximately A upon 1 plus A beta, that means the A upon A beta is approximately equal to 1/beta. That means overall our feedback system will be independent from the normal amplifier gain. Okay? That means this A up is depends on the value of beta. We can manipulate this value of beta, we can change this value of beta, we can manage this beta. That means our feedback system is very, very important. This feedback gain is only depends on the beta for the high value of loop gain. Okay. So in this lecture, I am trying to give you the good idea of the introduction of feedback amplifier. In next lecture, we will discuss frequency response of feedback amplifier, or in this topic number 2, that means the video lecture information 2, we will discuss in detail analysis of frequency amplifier. Even I will explain you frequency response of basic amplifier, that means I will explain you frequency response of low pass filter as well as high pass filter, and then I will explain you effect of feedback in low pass filter as well as high pass filter. Okay, thank you.